Hello friends, welcome back. So in this session, we will understand the most important concepts of embedded C++, and hopefully in next one or two sessions I could complete this playlist. So the first question, explain the relationship between access specifiers and inheritance. This is a very common and a very prominent question in any interview that is related to C++ or embedded C++. This talks about how the access specifiers gets derived as when you derive it from the base class to derived class. Let's see it. Base class, when it is public, protected and private, all these three are getting derived as public. They remain like this. Public remain public, protected remain protected, private remain private. And when it goes to protected inheritance method, when I derive them as protected, public and protected go protected and private remain private. When I derive them as private, public and protected remain, they get changed as private and private remains private. That's it. This is such a very important question. So remember this, and I hope this question is a very commonly asked question in most of the interviews. The next question is very most important. Explain the concept of virtual base class, and this is also called as classic diamond problem. What do you mean by classic diamond problem? Very simple. I'll explain you that right now. I have a base class, see my mouse pointer, I've got a base class here, I've got a derived class derived out of it, I've got another derived class derived out of it. Now I try to get the third derived class out of the both first two derived classes. I've got derived class 1, derived class 2, now these two give birth to the third derived class. Now what will happen is very simple. If I have a variable here in the base class, it will get a copy for derived class 1. The same copy will come to derived class 2, and now this third derived class will get confused as in which copy to use. For example, if it is the variable named x, now this derived class will be confused to use as in the x of derived class 1 or the x of derived class 2. Now this will lead to ambiguity, and this is a huge confusion which can be sorted out with virtual base class concept. Definitely we need coding to explain this, so I am going to have coding in parallel for you to understand this better. Now let's go step by step. I have got a base class, and in the base class I have got a variable by name x. Now I have a derived class 1, derived 1 is the name of the derived class, and I derive it with public rights from base class. Now what will happen? This x copy will be available for this derived class. Similarly, I come to derived class 2, I derive a class called as derived 2, and it is derived from base class again. Now the same copy of x will come here as well. Now we have the copy of x available with derived 1 and derived 2. Now what will happen is the beauty. I need to create a third class out of the derived 1 and derived 2, which means this test is derived from derived 1 and derived 2. And now inside that I have a function called as example, and in that function I try to access x. Now comes the story. I've got a base class A, I've got derived class B, I've got another derived class C. Now I use B and C to derive D. Now D is in trouble. Now what do? I go to main. In the main, I create an object for the third class test. Object.example. I am trying to access this example function from this object. Now what will happen is very simple. There will be confusion as in which x to be used. The x from the derived 1 or the x from derived 2 is to be used is the major confusion. And what you will get is an error that you see in front of you. X undeclared and reference to x is ambiguous. This is what you will get right in front of you, which is a mistake. Now, how do we avoid it, sir? Very simple. We can use virtual base class. What is it? Now, I go for the same code. There is a base class, and in that, there is something called as x. Now, I go for a derived one. The first derived class is here, but I added a keyword called as virtual here, which I'm highlighting right now, virtual, and I derive it from base class. Now, there will be a derived class 2 which is available here, and I use the keyword virtual again, and now what will happen is very simple. We will go back to the same diagram. I'll have a base class, I'll have a derived class 1, derived class 2. Now instead of having a x copy here and here, there will be only one copy in between, and that can be used by this third derived class which is going to come. When you use the keyword virtual, instead of it retaining multiple copies of the variables available in the base class, it will have only one copy, and now the problem is all sorted. The same function, I go to the same main function, test object, I create an object for the third class test, and I access the example function from the main. Now in this case, there will not be any ambiguity and the output will be perfect. So instead of you retaining multiple copies of a same variable which causes ambiguity and confusion, we get only one copy of the variable by using the keyword virtual, which is what I have shown you right now. Now we go to the final question of the session, pure virtual function. What is it? Very simple. The function is pure in all view. What do you mean by pure? The function does not have any content inside, is called pure virtual function. Now I'll explain you that with the code so that you can handle it easier in the interview. I got a base class. In the base class, I got a virtual void pure virtual function is equal to 0. Now what is it, sir? This function, pure virtual function is equal to 0, is called as pure virtual function because I assigned it with 0 and I closed it there. Now this function has got no content inside, and that's why we call it pure virtual function. And this function can be overridden in all the derived classes as per your wish. That's the beauty. Now I have just told that I have got a function this of this pattern, of this name. This will be definitely overridden in the derived classes, and this function is pure. I can put equal to 0, or I can put an open curly brace here and close curly brace here. That is also equivalent to the pure virtual function declaration. At the same time, many people follow equal to 0 because it is authentic and it is approved as per coding guidelines. Equal to 0 tells the programmer that this is pure virtual function. But when you open a bracket and close it, as such, people may understand, people may misunderstand that somebody has forgotten to return something there, somebody has forgotten to write something over there, and it might be overwritten. So to avoid this kind of confusion, people prefer equal to 0. Remember it, this is a very important point. Now assigning equal to 0 makes that function a pure virtual function, and you need to have the keyword virtual as well. Now what happens, I've got a derived class 1 from the base class. I obviously would have gotten the pure virtual function into it, so I'm overriding it now. I have got some print statement there. Now I come to derived class 2, I create another derived class from the base class, and again I'm overriding it. Now I go to the main function where I create an object and pointer. You can see that the same way as I have taught you the virtual class, the virtual function. Now derived class underscore one d1, I create an object for the derived class 1. Similarly, I create an object for the derived class 2, and now I assign the address of d1 to b, and I call pure virtual function. Now where it will go, it will have to go to the first one since it is d1. It would have called this perfectly. And now similarly, I go to d2. I assign the address of d2 and I call pure virtual function. So where it will go, it has to go to the second one. That's it. That's the output that you are getting in front of you. I have got the first derived class output, second derived class output. What did you learn here? Very simple. Creating a pure virtual function, and it is very abstract there, and it is definitely overridden there. Equal to 0 is the only best option that is preferred. You can also open the curly brace and close it, but don't prefer it unless and otherwise you are very sure of it. That's it. This is pure virtual function for you. We'll learn more about this in the next session. We'll have about maybe one or two sessions more to conclude this playlist. I hope you are enjoying this playlist. Thank you very much for the support. If you have any suggestions, input, queries, please go ahead and type it in the comment section. Thank you.